Hey everyone, welcome to PushCorp. I'm Isaiah Flora. I'm a robotics application engineer and certified abrasive specialist. We got a fresh demo coming at you. We're removing paint from steel cylinders. Let's check it out. All right, we're gonna talk through end of arm tooling, specific abrasives, and a little bit more in depth on the part. If you wanna skip all that and head to the application video, just hit that chapter below. Our part was brought to us by Tatum Industrial Automation based out of the UK. They're one of our longest distributor partnerships. We've been working with them for over 20 years. We'll link their contact info below. We can't disclose the actual part that the end user is using, but it's similar to this cylinder. The end user is wanting to weld two of these cylinders together. They come in painted, which affects the welding process, so we need to strip off the paint for them to be able to weld effectively. Since we shot the application video, I did some additional testing on the pipe. I ran out of gray paint, and that's why this pipe is white, and what you'll see in the video is gray. The end of arm tooling we used in the demo was an STC 0605 BT30 spindle. That's a max RPM of 6,000 with 5 horsepower, and it has an automatic tool changing collet. For the compliance, we use an AFD72. That's a passive unit, which is ideal for this situation because we're not changing orientation in relation to gravity. If you don't know the difference between passive and active, we'll link a detailed video below. And lastly, for the tooling, we used one of our stock BT30 tool holders with some custom metal flanges to hold the wheel. The abrasives we used in the demo were a 3M Scotch-Brite clean and strip wheel. This was our most aggressive option. It contains an extra coarse abrasive that provides a strong cutting action without damaging the base material. We tried the 3M Scotch-Brite EXL Pro Deburring Wheel because it has an open web that resists smearing as we're cleaning off the paint from this part. And lastly, we tried the Scotch-Brite Multi-Finishing Wheel. It provides a moderate aggressiveness with a lighter density construction and also is highly conformable. We use these abrasives for paint removal, but they're also commonly used in industries such as metalworking, composites, glass, for applications such as deburring, finishing, and polishing. We covered everything we used for this application. Let's jump into the video. Welcome back. As you can see in those finish photos, all three of the wheels left a different finish. Our sweet spot wheel ended up being the multi-finish wheel. It left a medium finish compared to the other two wheels, but was the most conformable, allowing us to hit any low spots on the part, removing all of the paint. So we chose to run one last stripe on the part with some optimized parameters, and that's what you saw at the end of the video. Thanks for joining us today. If you have any questions about what you saw or you want to see your parts being worked on in the demo lab, we'll link our contact info below. Please call us or email us. We'd love to talk to you. If you like the video, please like and subscribe, and you'll see all the fresh applications coming through the lab. We're gonna link a robotic finishing playlist so you can see some similar videos to this. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you on the next episode.